Myself Ashutosh Sadaria, and in this video we will discuss information communication technology subject which is taught in fourth semester of diploma engineering IT branch in GTU. First of all, the subject name is information communication technology and the subject code for the GTU is 3341601. Let me tell you little bit about subject first. The objective of information communication technology is to make student clear on how communication and information technology is inseparable. Course covers basic underlying concepts of information communication technology and techniques used most recently. After learning this course, you will be able to identify analog, digital and data communication techniques in communication technology. You will be able to identify traditional communication structure, its modulation, its multiplexing and lots of other important parameters. You will be able to identify types and significance of various network topologies, hardware and protocols deployed at each layers. Aim of the course is to develop basic understanding of information communication technology and IT ethics, and to develop basic skills to identify and learn various networks, servers, protocols in different modes of communication. Then let's see the examination scheme of the subject. Total marks of the subject is 150. The examinations are divided in two parts, theory and practical. Theory is of 100 marks and practical is of 50 marks. Theory is of 100 marks and practical is of 50 marks. In theory, you will have 70 marks written paper at the end of the semester, and then in 30 marks for the progressive assessments. In this, your institute will mostly consider test and mid-semester exams conducted during the semester, and then in practical, 20 marks as progressive assessment. In this, your institute will consider practical you performed during the semester, and 30 marks as ESE. In this, your institute will take practical exams or VIVA at the end of the semester. So let's see the subject syllabus. This subject is divided in 5 units. The first is ICT fundamentals, then next is data networks, then physical view of ICT, then network addressing, and the last is protocols and data transportation. The first unit is ICT. In this, we will see information technology and various information technology philosophy, what is the need of information technology, its definitions, information and society, and information processing cycles. And also we will see IT Act of India, and in brief we will see ICT models and different analog and digital communications. And then we will see basic structures of ICT like structure of communication, transmission modes like simplex, half duplex, full duplex, then synchronous and asynchronous transmission, then parallel and serial communications. Then we will see analog communication, and in this analog communication we will see need of modulation like amplitude modulation and frequency modulation. The second unit is data networks. In this we will see models of network computing, then client server network and peer-to-peer network, then network topologies like bus, mesh, star, ring, etc. Then various types of computer networks like LAN, MAN, WAN, then various types of switching networks like circuit switching and packet switching, and the needs of layered mechanism. Then we will see in brief OSI model and TCP/IP model. The third unit is physical view of ICT. In this we will see multiplexing and definition and need of multiplexing, and different types of multiplexing like time division multiplexing, frequency division multiplexing, code division multiplexing and orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. And then we will see various transmission media like wired media, wireless media, and application of wireless media in satellite communication, types of orbit, and Indian achievement in satellite technology. And then we will see network connecting devices like switch, router, repeater, bridges and gateway. And then we will see IEEE standards for them. Then in the fourth unit we will see network addressing. The first one is IPv4 addressing, and in this IPv4 addressing we will see need of IPv address, IPv4 addressing scheme, address space and notations, mask, net ID, host ID, subnetting, supernetting, and classful and classless notations. And then in IPv6 addressing, we will see need of the IPv6 migration from IPv4, then IPv6 addressing scheme, hexadecimal column notation, unicast address, multicast address, anycast address, reserved address and local addresses. Then we will see other concepts like address mapping from logical to physical and physical to logical, and print, ping and trace route commands. Then in the fifth unit, we will see protocols and data transportation. In this, we will see UDP and TCP protocols, connectionless and connection-oriented communication, and reliable and unreliable communication. Then we will see data traffic and congestion management. And then we will also see domain name system. In this, we will see domain name, domain zone, root server, domain types, address resolution, address mapping, and address, mapping address to names, and recursive resolution, and iterative resolution, and caching. Then we will see protocols like ARP, RARP, ICMP protocols, then routing table, unicast routing protocols, and multicast routing protocols. Then we will see SMTP, POP, IMAP like protocols, and then WWW and HTTP. Then we will see data link layer protocols like simplest, stop and wait ARQ, go back NARQ, and selective repeat ARQ. Then let's see the importance of the subject. By learning this subject, student will understand importance of information and information communication technology and understanding of Indian IT Act. Then student will learn basic analog communication concept and identify network, servers, topologies and related components. Then student will also learn protocols and IEEE standards and also the understanding and setup and configuration of LAN. So that's it for this video. Hope you have understood all about basic introduction of information communication technology. Thank you.